In this segment, we'll look at how you will obtain the financial ratios, as well as the liquidity and activity ratios. We are getting our ratios from Reuters.com. So, first, go to www.reuters.com. From there, select Markets, and then scroll down and select Stocks. Now we enter the company name or ticker symbol. For example, Apple is AAPL, and I hit search. Reuters wants to show the exchange, so AAPL.O is telling us that it's on the NASDAQ exchange. Okay, so I will select that. And we go to the overview page for Apple. A few of the ratios are contained on the overview page. We can see that Apple is at $490 today, and the price change is it is up $1.32. A little bit of a roller coaster. A few of the ratios are found on the overview page. We have the price earnings ratio and earnings per share here, as well as dividend, dollar amount, and dividend yield. When you see a ratio with TTM after it, that means it is calculated using the trailing 12 months or the last 12 months. Now, back up to the menu bar, select Financials. Under the Financials tab, we get the ratios. We don't really get the balance sheet or income statement. At the top of the page, we will see some historical data on revenue and earnings, estimates of what analysts think future sales and earnings will be, and finally we get down to our ratios. Valuation ratios are what we call market ratios, and you see the company and the industry there. We'll be using both. Then we have dividend ratios, growth rates, and finally what they call financial strength ratios. We call the first couple liquidity ratios, and then the next several are leverage ratios. We're going to start looking at individual ratios by looking at the current ratio. And the current ratio is calculated using MRQ. When you see MRQ, that means the most recent quarter. So it is not a measure of 12 months, it's just the last quarter. These ratios are as up to date as they can be. They're using the latest financial information available. That's why we're looking at them too, not going all the way back to the last annual report for everything. Liquidity ratios answer the question, can the company meet its obligations over the short term, i.e., is there enough cash to pay the bills? And it measures how many dollars of short-term assets are available for every dollar of short-term liabilities owned. And it's simply calculated by taking current assets and dividing by current liabilities. Generally, the higher the ratio, the more the liquidity. Microsoft, for example, has a current ratio of 2.71. This means that for every dollar in current liabilities, Microsoft has $2.71 in current assets to pay those bills. Apple, on the other hand, has a ratio of 1.88. So we would say Microsoft is more liquid than Apple. Here's a couple that are a little more extreme. Walmart has a liquidity ratio of 0.83. This means that for every dollar in current liabilities, Walmart only has 83 cents in current assets. Will Walmart be able to pay its bills? Well, it is Walmart. Yes, it will. And this is because Walmart pays its vendors slowly and is very, very efficient in cash and asset management. Fastenal, on the other hand, has a liquidity ratio of 5.95, almost 6. So that means for every current liability that they have, every dollar in current liabilities, they have $6 almost in current assets. Why? Well, Fastenal is a very conservative company and always has a lot of cash. Is it better to have a very, very high current ratio? Well, not necessarily. Cash does not generate much income. You don't earn much interest on cash these days, but it does provide safety. Who uses these ratios? A very important set of users is vendors. Vendors will look at the financial statements of a company to see if they believe the company will be able to pay them on time if they give the company credit. This is one of the most commonly used ratios. Another liquidity ratio is the quick ratio. Answers the same question, but it looks at what they call quick assets. In the quick ratio, we subtract inventory because it is not as quick to turn inventory into cash as it is to turn accounts receivable, typically 30 days, cash, and investments into cash to pay liabilities. So sometimes this shows a different story. Again, Microsoft, more liquid according to this measure than Apple. Look at Walmart. For every dollar in current liabilities, they only have 24 cents in quick assets. Very low. Fastenal, still, for every dollar in current liabilities, $2.88 in quick assets. Okay, very strong in liquidity. Again, used by vendors who want to know if they will be paid on time. Also used by management to help them determine, do they have enough liquidity or not enough liquidity? A second type of ratios is what is called asset management or activity ratios. These are more what I think of as a measure of speed. For example, the accounts receivable turnover measures how quickly is the company collecting or turning over its accounts receivable. The turnover is calculated by dividing annual sales by the accounts receivable. And the number of days sales in receivable is measured by taking 365 days in the year and dividing by the receivables turnover that you just calculated. For example, Microsoft's accounts receivable turnover is 4.68 times per year. This means that they have 78 days in accounts receivable. Is this good or bad? Well, this can depend on the industry. But for example, if the terms that they gave their customers were 30 days, in other words, their customers were supposed to pay in 30 days, 78 days would be very bad. Okay? What we can say is that Apple, with a turnover of 20 and only 18 days in receivables, has a faster and therefore better accounts receivable turnover than Microsoft. Who uses this ratio? This ratio is very commonly used by management. It can help determine whether they're being paid on time according to their credit terms, whether there is trouble, they need to go out and really work on collecting accounts, and it can be used to evaluate the performance of the accounts receivable department or accounts receivable management. Another activity ratio is the inventory turnover. How quickly is the company selling or turning its inventory? I think of grocers. When you have fresh produce, you expect them to turn over that inventory every few days. This ratio will vary widely by industry. Calculated similar to the accounts receivable turnover. Microsoft has a turnover of 13 times. They have 28 days sales in inventory, okay? Measured in days, and it's always whole days. We don't have like 28.2 days. We round it up to the nearest day. Apple, on the other hand, has a turnover of 74 times per year, which means they only have 5 days sales in inventory. Now Microsoft, what do they have in inventory? Software and maybe tablets. Apple, you would think, would have more inventory, but they've been very efficient in having the people that are manufacturing products for them and their dealers hold the inventory. So they have very little invested in inventory at any time. The faster the better, so the higher ratio, the better. And again, this is used by management to manage performance and monitor activity and trouble spots. One really key ratio for a company that will impact the total performance of the company is the total asset turnover. It answers the question, how efficiently is the company using its assets to generate sales overall? So for the turnover, we take the total sales divided by total assets. The higher the ratio, the better or faster. The lower the ratio, the slower the turn or worse. For example, Microsoft at September 30th had a total asset turnover, or TAT, of 0.59. Apple, on the other hand, had a turnover of 0.93, so that is better. That's almost almost one. What this means is that for every dollar in total assets, Apple generated 93 cents in sales. Again, this is a very key ratio, and it is used pretty much by everyone who is evaluating the company. In the next segment, we'll take a look at profitability ratios.